Hello again, I'm Bee. I'm back again with a new Unreal tutorial. This time, we are going to explore how to move an actor and reach a target. Let's review the code. We have this actor, which is a blueprint that extends from an actor. And it's just a simple mesh with a root scene and the arrow. And this whole blueprint extends from this move actor example 3, which is an actor. So we have the name of the class, which extends from an actor, just a normal actor that you can place on any scene and it will have a basic transform. It has the root scene and it has the static mesh. Nothing new. In the constructor is where we create its element, the root scene and the mesh. For the movement of the actor towards that target, I have two important properties. The first one is a public property. This is the actor target, that cube, and it's a new property. In this case, it's edit instance only, so I can only edit this property on an instance, not on the blueprint, and it's also blueprint read only. If I go to the scene and select this object, we can see in this section, which is this section, custom section that I set for myself, we can see that I selected the target cube, which is this object. So I can set this property only with this is an instance. So that instance only doesn't appear on the blueprint because I need to select that on the scene. The other U property is the speed of the movement. And I set this as edit anywhere, so I can edit that in the blueprint and on instances. And blueprint read only. And finally, for the movement, I have these protected properties. I have the direction for the movement, I have the total distance, the current distance, and the start location. In the begin play is when I set some of those properties. First, I always like to check if I have the target, otherwise that this code doesn't make any sense, so this will prevent any kind of null references. I get the start location. After that, I get the direction, which is the target location, and I subtract the start location. This will give us a vector on that direction. Next thing is to get the total distance, and that's basically the size of this vector. I have here this UL log, so I can see if that's correct or not. And this is very important. This is to make this vector director one size. And finally, I set the current distance to 0. The movement happens on the tick. So every frame, the actor will move on the direction that we set on the begin play. Again, I have this null check to make sure that this can happen. And I only move this actor when the current distance is less than the total distance. This means when the current distance is more than the total distance, that means that the actor reached the location. That means that the actor, the robot, has reached the target. Okay, but the movement is simple. I just get the current location, its frame. I use the direction that we calculated at the beginning and apply the speed and also the delta time, so this will be frame independent. And I set the actor location with this new location. So this vector is size 1, so it will add these two variables. And finally, I recalculate the current distance that we have from the current distance, and I subtract the start location. And after that, I get the size of this. So this will give me the current distance from the start location, not the target location, the start location. So this way I can know exactly when I'm gonna stop to move the object. If we simulate this example again, we can see the little robot will go towards this actor target and will stop there. If we take a look at the output log, we will see that we can get the total distance in the begin play. If I move this far away, we will get a different distance. So the little robot always moves towards that direction. I use this example all the time. It's very useful for many things. We could improve this example adding some acceleration so the little robot won't go in constant speed. We can also rotate the object on the begin play to face that target. So if, for example, if the target is over here, if we could rotate this robot, it will face that first and move. But that's an example for another video. For this tutorial, this is enough. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to press like. And if you want to get notifications for next videos, click that bell button. Thank you. Bye.